So a lot of times, such kind of patients are seen especially also in diabetics as well. So this is what we are going to try to speak about. How is diabetes related to those heart failure patients, in fact? So when they tried to do a data analysis of such heart failure patients, they were able to see there is a lot of group of patients who are having heart failure, but the etiology was rather than hypertension, the coronary artery disease, but also diabetes as well. And why we are trying to speak about it, even today over here as well, is the main reason is India, countries like India and China, they are the world's diabetes capital. India is also going to overtake China as a diabetes capital, in fact. And it is going to be the house for the most number of diabetic patients. So that is why those people are also predisposed for this. So that is why, as I was telling you, if you will try to see on an overall basis, 1/3 of the heart failure patients. So those people, if you will try to go for the etiology, in fact, 1/3 of them will be having heart failure or with diabetes, in fact. And the problem, as we all are aware, that in a diabetic patient, what we try to see is for the sugar levels, yes. For the cholesterol levels, yes. What about those associated comorbid conditions? But are we trying to take care for the heart failure? Most of the times, no. And that is the reason those kind of patients start developing those complications. So these are some of these other drugs as well which we should try to think for, especially for the diabetics. Is, rather than just ACE inhibitor or beta blocker, but also a newer group of drugs which is called as ARNI inhibitors. In fact, okay, so ARNI is a special molecule. So this is actually more of a basics. So I'll tell you, we will finish it and in the end we'll speak. Okay, so this was one of the landmark study which is called as Paradigm HF study, which was the, as I said it, so after this study only, the molecule like ARNI which was cited, so that was approved even for the heart failure. And when they tried to see in the details of the study, as I said, almost 1/3 of those patients did have a diabetes. In fact, when they tried to see for the HbA1c, it is called as the glycosylated hemoglobin. So how good was the control for those patients? So they could see a lot of similar patients as well, they were not having such a good control as well. In fact, there was when you try to talk about those absolute number of those patients, nearly 4,000 were having the diabetes just on the basis of the history as well, which those patients were having. And when they tried to see further in the details of those patients, they were older patients, they were fragile, and they were also having those other comorbid conditions as well. So this is the pie chart when they tried to see what kind of those diabetic patients were having. So some patients were, of course, pre-diabetes as well. Some were having frank diabetes. However, there was a good number of patients as well, which was not even diagnosed. So what I would like to say, even in the Western world, such kind of problems do happen. It's not like this that, you know, the undiagnosed patients are there only in the Asia or only in the Africa or Latin America, but even in the most developed countries as well, because Paradigm HF study did enroll patients from the different parts of the world. We all are interested in about the end outcomes, in fact. So similarly, when they tried with the to see with the passage of time, how about those cardiovascular death as well? So they were able to notice those patients who were having diabetes, they were significantly associated, of course, with mortality and also with the morbidity. So for example, the problems which were there, they were much more pronounced in those with the diabetes. However, those patients who didn't have any diabetes, of course, they were doing much, much better when we try to compare with those other patients. So there were various parameters which were enrolled for that. Some of the parameters included the cardiovascular death rate, the heart failure, and even the all-cause mortality as well. So when they tried to see, so these all parameters were pretty much high for those diabetics, in fact. So that is where they tried to see for this special molecule about ARNI. So does it affect the glycemic status? And what about those end outcomes as well? So when they tried to see, for example, with the versus enalapril versus the drug, so they could see most of the time. So this is what is called as a forest plot. So if we will look carefully in this forest plot, so of course the data tends to favor the ARNI inhibitor, in fact. So even in the HbA1c, so when they tried to see those patients who were there on sacubitril valsartan, the unique combination of drug, so they were doing much, much better, even in terms of the glycosylated hemoglobin as well. So as we all are aware, insulin tends to form a good bulk of patients as well who are taking insulin, in fact. So when they try to see, with the progression of passage of time as well, those patients who were using insulin as well, there was a further reduction, almost one third, nearly 29% in fact. And one of the other adverse effects, which is pretty common in such patients, it is hypertension. So when they try to see for the hypertension as well, does it affect, especially with this molecule? No, it doesn't seem to affect. So let me try to summarize. So to summarize, what we all can understand is there is a good number of patients with heart failure who are diabetes. So we should try to treat those diabetic endpoints, of course, but also the heart failure problems as well.